So before yesterday we were discussing about the principle of calorimeter, principle of calorimetry or principle of mixture, both are same. So according to that, what will be the heat lost by hot object is equal to heat gained by cold body, provided what was the condition? There is no transfer of heat between calorimeter and its surrounding. That is, whatever heat is lost by the hot object, the total heat is gained by cold body. Then only it will be valid. Or that is our assumption, or that is the limitation. No? Limitation is under what condition this principle is valid. So limitation is what? There is no transfer of heat between calorimeter and its surrounding. That is the limitation. So sometimes it is asked, what is limitation of this rule or this law, or what is your assumption? When especially when numerical will be asked, then it will be asked, what is your assumption? So on what basis you have calculated whatever you will give the answer? Okay. So we have written that one. This statement we have done. Now explanation. So suppose we are considering, let a hot object or hot body of mass M1 kept at temperature, maybe T1 or theta 1, whatever you may assume, be mixed. It is not a mixture. Maybe an iron ball is dropped into water, that also we say it is mixed. So anyhow, the two objects are in thermal contact. That is the meaning of mixed here. So it is not like mixture or compound. Cold object of mass M2 or specific capacity we forgot here. Specific heat capacity S2. Okay, here also we have that. Mass M1 is specific heat capacity S1 kept at temperature theta 1 be mixed with cold body of mass M2 specific heat capacity to S2 maintained at temperature theta 2. So this is the condition. A hot object is mixed with cold object. Maybe hot water is poured on the red hot, sorry. Water is poured on the red hot iron ball, or hot iron ball is dropped into water, or there is a vessel in which hot water is poured. So hot water will lose heat, vessel will gain heat. So that will depend on different situation, whatever is given in there. So two objects are there, one is hot, another is cold. Let the temperature of mixture, which also we call equilibrium temperature, be theta. That is, when thermal equilibrium is achieved, that is, no heat is lost by the hot object, No heat is gained by the cold object. When they will acquire, both will acquire the same temperature, so transfer of heat will stop. And that stage we call thermal equilibrium. So let at the thermal equilibrium, the temperature of mixture be theta. Then according to principle of calorimetry, what will be? Then what will be? So heat lost by hot object. Be mass into specific heat capacity into falling temperature. Suppose theta I have here right. Mass because will lose heat. So falling temperature or delta theta, whatever you may say, give this symbol. M1, S1, delta theta, F, okay. Whatever symbol you can use. So what is that? Mass is M1, specific density S1, and falling temperature is its temperature has decreased from theta 1 to theta. The hot object was at temperature theta 1 and final temperature is theta. So its temperature has dropped from theta 1 to theta. Now, cold body. Its temperature has increased from theta 2 to theta. The temperature of cold object will increase, temperature of hot object will decrease. So heat gained by cold body will be how much?
Is it M1 minus S1 or M1 into S1?
Yes.
Is it M1 minus S1 or M1 into S1?
Into mass into specific heat capacity into change in temperature. That is the formula, no? Amount of heat Q is MS delta theta or C into theta. If heat capacity is given, then C into theta or delta theta, you can say. So heat gained by cold body will be how much? Its mass into specific capacity into delta theta rise. Here temperature will rise. Or theta r or whatever symbol you can use. So here mass is M2, specific capacity S2, and rise in temperature theta minus theta 2. Its temperature will increase from theta 2 to theta. Yes, any confusion? So according to principle of calorimetry, what should be? This must be equal to this. That is the mathematically, you can say principle of calorimetry, or this is the explanation of principle of calorimetry. So according to principle of calorimetry, M1, S1, theta 1 minus theta must be equal to M2, S2, theta minus theta 2. So this way we are using the principle of calorimetry. So always we will use this concept only. Who is going to lose heat? It may be more than one object may lose heat, or more than one object may gain heat. Here we have assumed only two. Practically, you will have to first identify which object is going to lose heat, or which are the objects they are losing heat, or which are the objects that are gaining heat. After that, individually you will calculate what is the heat lost by this object, what is heat lost by this object if more than one is losing. Similarly, what is heat gained by this particular object, or heat gained by this particular object, and finally what will be total heat lost by all the hot object will be equal to total heat lost by all the cold object. Now, diagram of calorimeter, that is given in your book. So diagram is given in your page number 265. So sometimes this level diagram is asked. So nice diagram, you have to practice by seeing the book. Just to have an idea, we are I'm drawing this diagram in a rough way. So, what is calorimeter? So, calorimeter is basically a copper vessel. This vessel, just a small beaker we can see. So there is a vessel whose shape is like beaker. Capacity may be 100 ml or 120 ml depending on whatever where it is used or for what purpose we are using. In our lab, it may be capacity, suppose 140 ml like that. So this copper vessel is highly polished from both sides. Highly polished means it is not like mirror. The surface is made smooth. It should not be rough. If surface is rough, then what will be? It will absorb heat from the surrounding. Rough surface or black color surface, it will absorb heat from the surrounding, and that we don't want. So that's why it is highly polished. So calorimeter is made up of what? Is a copper vessel. Of very thin wall. Polished from both sides. that is inner and outer surface both are polished. What is the purpose of this? Here two questions are asked. Why calorimeter is made up of copper? Why not any other material? So two questions are based on this construction. Why calorimeter is made up of copper? So as we know, copper is very good conductor of heat. In fact, it is the second best conductor of heat. The best conductor is silver, which is very costly, so we don't use silver. So second best conductor, one is this region. Other is its specific heat capacity is also very low. The specific capacity of copper is 0.4 joule per gram degree Celsius. Water is 4.2, so nearly 10 times more. That is, if we are giving same amount of heat to copper and to water of same mass, then rising temperature of copper will be 10 times that of water. So it is very good conductor. And secondly, specific heat capacity of copper is very low. These are the two reasons why we prefer. What will happen if it is good conductor? Why we prefer a good conductor? So that transfer of heat between the hot and cold object may be very quick. Within no time, the transfer of heat may take place. So it is good conductor, so that what will be? Transfer of heat between hot and cold may take place within no time or very short interval of time. And it is good conductor, so this is the use. Now second is specific copper capacity of copper is very low. So what will happen with this? As specific capacity is very low, so what will happen? It will absorb or lose very less amount of heat. So that by losing or by gaining very small amount of heat, it can acquire the temperature of mixture. So what is the benefit here? If we neglect this calorimeter, then also there will be not much less difference in the result. That is, error in the calculation will be very less. Though for exact calculation, we consider calorimeter also. But if we neglect the calorimeter, only whatever hot object or whatever cold object is placed inside it, if we consider that only, then also the calculation will be approximately correct. Okay, so these are the two reasons why we are using, why calorimeter is made up of copper. Now another is, why it is polished? Why both side is polished? Inner side also as well as outer side also. So in this calorimeter, what is happening? Some liquid is placed, any hot object or cold object will be placed. So one will be, at least one should be liquid state only. Other may be solid or may be liquid, no problem. So when this calorimeter is polished, what will be? The heat radiation which is incident on the inner surface will be reflected that side only. The heat radiation which is coming from the outer one, that will be reflected throughout. Our purpose is what? There should not be any transfer of heat between calorimeter and surrounding. That is our purpose. So we will have to avoid conduction, convection and radiation, all three. So radiation is prohibited here. Due to radiation, heat transfer will not take place between surrounding and calorimeter. For that only its inner as well as outer surface is polished. So inner and outer surface of calorimeter is polished in order to minimize the transfer of heat. Between calorimeter and its surrounding. Due to radiation. So due to radiation, there should not be any transfer of heat. For that only we are polishing this surface. Here polishing means the surface is becoming very smooth. Polishing doesn't mean it is mirror-like surface. So we have stop radiation. So there are three modes of transfer of heat: conduction, convection, and radiation. So in order to avoid this conduction and convection, this calorimeter or this vessel is kept in a wooden box. Labeling is given in your book. We are not labeling it properly, so you have to see the diagram on labeling from the book. Just I'm making you understand what is the meaning, why we have used. So this wooden box is there, and between this box and the vessel, the material used is insulating material is used, that is wool or felt. So if it is asked why copper vessel is placed in a wooden box and the gap is filled with insulating material, what is the reason? It is so to minimize the transfer of heat between calorimeter and surrounding due to conduction. to minimize the transfer, transfer of heat between calorimeter and its surrounding, due to conduction, the copper vessel is placed in a wooden box. And the gap is filled with wool or felt, the insulating material. Now, so we have stopped radiation, we have stopped conduction. Now one more method is there, that is convection.
Convection.
So in order to minimize the loss due to convection, insulating cover is used. This cover has got two holes. Through one hole, a sensitive thermometer is placed. And this through other hole, one stirrer is placed. So this is insulating cover. This we call stirrer. This thermometer should be sensitive. And this is the copper vessel, highly polished from both sides. So this is the final figure of this calorimeter. So this stirrer is what? This is simply a copper wire which is bent in this form. Here is one ring and here is simply wire is taken out. So in order to minimize the transfer of heat between calorimeter and its surrounding due to convection, what is used? A lead of insulating material. So a lead of insulating material is used to cover this wooden box. The complete box is covered. So this lead has got two holes. Through one hole, a sensitive thermometer is inserted. Sensitive means what? Which can record a small change in temperature, because here the rise or fall in temperature will be of the order of maximum 3 to 4 degrees, not more than that. So we must use a sensitive thermometer so that if very small change is there, maybe 0.5 degree change or maybe 1 degree change, that also it can record. What is the, and through other hole this stirrer is inserted. What is the purpose of the stirrer? So before, because thermometer is placed at one place. So when we drop this hot iron ball, temperature of this region will be different, temperature of this region will be different. It will take much time to get the temperature throughout the mixture swing, because water is not good conductor. So it will take some time. So we don't have that much time. Otherwise, what will be? If we leave for a longer period, the surrounding will be affected. And we want this process to take place within no time. Otherwise, and this is not highly polished like mirror, so radiation will take place. Wooden box and this woolen will not be perfect insulator. So conduction will take place. Here holes are there. So convection will take place. So we can only minimize, it is not stopping it like thermos flask. It is not stopping like up to that extent. So only thing is, this transfer of heat may take place within 1 second only, not more than that time. And we will record the temperature. So what will be? We will use this stirrer. We will mix throughout the liquid for same everywhere. We will mix it properly. We will stir it properly before taking the reading. That is the purpose of this stirrer. So before taking the reading, this stirrer is used to stir this liquid or the mixture, so that whatever the temperature of this region, same is here or same is here, everywhere temperature is same. We are recording the temperature at a particular point, particular place. So it should be, temperature should be same. Okay. So this is about calorimeter construction and its working, how it works, and calculation how we do that already we have done before and only. So here, first of all, mass of this copper vessel is taken. Copper vessel and this stirrer, both are made up of same material, that is copper. So mass of calorimeter, if it is given the numerical, that means this is the mass of this copper vessel and the stirrer. Not this whole wooden box or like that. That is not there. That is useless. So mass of this copper vessel and stirrer, that we call the mass of calorimeter. So in this case, suppose the calorimeter contains water at room temperature, and we are putting a hot ball, iron ball or brass ball. So this experiment we'll do in the lab to determine the specific capacity of brass ball. In class 9, the brass ball which I have used for the pendulum, same ball will be used here again, and will determine the specific heat capacity of that ball, that is brass. So if mass of the calorimeter means mass of the vessel and stirrer, so you have three things are there: calorimeter, water and brass ball. So brass ball is heated, we'll put in boiling water, and that ball will be transferred here. So that ball will lose heat, whereas this water and calorimeter both will gain heat. So after doing the necessary calculation, we will be able to find the specific heat capacity of that brass ball or brass material. Because special capacity depend only on material. Now next one is where we use the high specific capacity that already we have discussed here for yesterday. High specific capacity of water. So mainly for two purpose. One is cooling, and other is fermentation. So water is used as coolant. Where we use water as coolant?
Radiators.
In car radiator or engine radiator, or in the generator also radiator, we are using water.
Nuclear power plants.
Now, where water is used as heat reservoir? That is during fermentation or in hot water bottle. So water as coolant. Coolant means it can absorb large amount of heat from the hot object. That hot object will be cold, but its temperature will not become too high. No? So it is cooling down the engine of the car. So that's why the name is coolant. It can cool down other hot object. Not water is not cooling itself. Temperature of water will rise, but it will not rise too much. So that is the function of coolant. So it is used in car radiator. Water is used as, not as, water as coolant and as heat reservoir. This is during fermentation. Or in hot water bottle. This hot water bottle is used, or hot water placed in a gunny bag is used, or it is placed over the part of the body which is wounded or which has got some wound, then it gives the relief from the pain. If any pain is taking place anywhere on the body, then hot water bottle is placed or the gunny bag filled with hot water is used, and it gives the great relief. That process we call fermentation. So this is used. Some other uses are given in your books. You have to read these points, or these reasoning type questions is asked. Natural phenomena and consequences of high specific capacity of water. First is the climate near the sea. So already we have discussed yesterday. Hot water bottle, okay, already discussed. Water is used as effective coolant, that is also discussed. In cold countries, water is used as heat reservoir for wine, okay. This is what? As the specific capacity of water is very high, so what will be during cold country or during cold region, what will be? The wine bottles or any juice bottle is placed inside this water. So these bottles are kept inside water. What will happen with that?
Hot water, sir.
So the specific capacity of water is very high. So though the temperature of the surrounding may become minus 9 degree or minus 5 degree, whatever it is, but then also this water will not freeze. As the specific capacity of water is very high, so it will have to do large amount of heat before freezing. So this water will not freeze, and this juice or wine will remain in liquid state. It will not solidify. Same is this one also. Farmer fill their field. So when frost, the weather forecast is the frost, then what will be if field is empty, then frost will heat the plant or the field. So temperature of the plant water which is present in the plant cell may go below 0 degree and it may freeze. And if it freezes, then what will happen? The volume of that water will, when water freezes, ice is formed, the volume will become more than water. So volume of the ice, if the water which is present in the cell, if it converts into ice, the volume increases and it will damage the cell. So if it damages the cell, what will be? The plant will not be able to survive. So if frost is the weather forecast, then farmers fill their field with water. So naturally, what will be? When water is present and frost is coming, the temperature will not go below 0 degree. Because specific capacity of water is very high. So before freezing, it will lose large amount of heat. And where it will go? Surrounding is not able to take that heat. So that's why the temperature of plant cell will not go below zero, or the water which is present in the plant cell will not freeze. Similarly, other regions may be all plants and animals have got very high percentage of water. So our body has got nearly 5%. What is the percentage of water in our body?
75%.
72% or so. Okay, so nearly 80% or 75%, whatever be. So it helps our body to maintain temperature, same temperature throughout the year, whether it is summer season, whether it is winter season, our body temperature is same, that is maintained due to the presence of water only. Because for a small fall or a small rise in temperature, water requires very large amount of heat. And that much amount of heat is not given by the surrounding. So that's why our body is able to, or anybody, any plant or any animal, body is able to maintain its temperature. Okay, high and low heat capacity, these are the three which is given in the book. The base of cooking pan is made thick. So if it is thick, what will happen? It can, its heat capacity will increase. So it can absorb large amount of heat from the flame, that is from the source, and can transfer the heat to the material which is to be cooked. Similarly, this one, base of electric press, you can read that one, same region is there. Okay, now how to solve the numericals.
Time up, sir.
Time up. Oh yeah. Okay.
What that teacher will join?
So you try to solve with the numericals which are given in the book. Next day we will discuss the numericals, which is based on this part. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.